Hello YouTube, welcome back to my channel, and in this video I'll be discussing the battery life on my brand new OnePlus 7T. Now OnePlus also released the 7T Pro, which is a slightly more souped up version as opposed to what we have on the 7T. There are two main differences between the two phones. On the 7T, you got a 3800 mAh battery with a full HD Plus screen, as opposed to the 7T Pro, which has got a 4085 mAh battery along with a quad HD screen. So when you look at the stats from battery to screen ratio, you got a 200 extra milliamp on top as opposed to the 7T, and you got a slightly bigger screen as well on the 7T Pro. So I think it levels out pretty much the same when it comes to battery life, and that's exactly what I've been hearing in the media, on the reviews, and a few people I've spoken to. The battery life on both the phones is pretty much on par. It's just a matter of personal preference. I have been very happy with the battery life, and along with a nice crisp and clear AMOLED full HD Plus screen with no issues whatsoever. Now before getting into the battery stats, but in my typical style, I will give you screenshots of both 4G and Wi-Fi along with standby times. Let's quickly run through the basic specs of the OnePlus 7T. Now let's get into the phone. The reliable in-screen fingerprint sensor has been working perfectly for me without any issues. So going into settings and then going into about phone, and here you guys, you can see the phone has got a Snapdragon 855 Plus, which is the latest version of the Snapdragon chipset, along with 8 gigs of RAM and 128 gigs of storage. Three triple cameras, which we have discussed already in my unboxing, and also I've put up some camera samples, but please do keep an eye on my social media. I'm still testing the camera as we speak. Further, also 90Hz fluid AMOLED, a 6.55 inch display. This 90Hz will be discussed in this video and see how it affects the battery life. Also device 7T, Android version 10, of course, that's what the phone came out with. Out of the box, Oxygen OS 10.0.6, as you can see, and model HD 1903 and the other specs. So without wasting any more time, let's quickly get started. On the first screenshot, as you can see, I took the screenshot on 17th of November at 10 past 1 in the morning. The battery was down to 64%, and then when I checked it again at 9:43 when I got up, the battery was down to 57%, meaning it lost nearly 9% in about approximately around 9 hours. So that's 1% every hour. I will discuss the standby later in the video, so do stay tuned. An update came which did improve this standby time. Now all the screenshots taken from now this point onwards are on 60Hz, but as soon as in the middle of the video I changed to 90Hz, you will be notified along with the proof as screenshot. Okay, so an update came straight away on the very first day when I was actually using the phone. As you can see, optimized standby power consumption. This update did actually improve the standby stats, which I will show you later in the video. Like I said, optimized expanded screenshot feature, and again optimized the Bluetooth connectivity in automobiles, and also improved system stability and general bug fixes. Out of these four, two I can tell you I did see the difference. First one, optimized standby power consumption, which we will talk in just a moment, and also optimize the Bluetooth connectivity in automobiles. Now when I was using Android Auto before the update on the very first day, I did hear a bit of crackling. The Bluetooth was breaking up every now and then, and ever since the update, my connection to my car is a lot more stable. Also Bluetooth plus on top Android Auto, both were cracking before the update, but after the update it has significantly improved. Still a bit of cracking though, and I hope the new update, maybe another update which will come eventually at some point, will improve that. However, it is a lot better than it was initially before. Okay, now here we go, 90%. I took the screenshot once again guys, and the battery went all the way down to 41%, as you can see. And I did use Chrome, Instagram, YouTube, WhatsApp, Twitter, Outlook, voice calls, you name it, I did it all. And eventually I was able to capture a total of 4 hours and 47 minutes of screen on time. This is, by the way, at 41%. The battery hadn't died down. The reason I took the screenshot at 41% was because I was going out for a few hours and I knew the battery won't last. So it was my very first day. I had to make some quick phone calls, also I had to travel as well, so I thought let's leave it here for now. And from the next day onward, I did let the battery go down all the way so I could take a full usage screenshot. So next up, at 41%, I took another screenshot on 28th of November, just past midnight, and when I checked it just before 12 p.m. in the afternoon, once again, the battery standby consumption was significant, even though the update had been applied already, but seemed like it wasn't working as effectively. Anyways, further down, you can see the battery was down to 8%, yet another reading from full 100%, as you guys can see. And then Chrome, YouTubing, social media, all bits and bobs, making voice calls and everything else. Eventually, I was able to capture 6 hours and 48 minutes of screen on time. Now, this was a proper use, going all the way up to 100% and then going down to pretty much the end of the battery, 8%. And that's where I got, like I said, 6 hours and 48 minutes of screen on time. All this time, the brightness was kept around 70%. And those of you who follow me regularly, you guys know this already. I don't keep my brightness all the way to the top because it gets really, really bright. So normally, I tend to keep it around 60 to 70%, depending on what time of the day I'm using the phone. Okay, so back to the screenshot then. Once again, like I said, 8%, and then I got 6 hours and 48 minutes of screen on time, and this was, by the way, on Wi-Fi. Okay, next up, once again, I took another screenshot, a 9%, as you can see, lots of browsing on Chrome, WhatsApp, Insta, heavy social media usage, emails, camera, and everything else. And again, I was able to achieve this time 7 hours and 28 minute of screen on time. This is probably the best I've had so far, so it wasn't looking too bad. And as you can see, once the update was applied, slowly the phone was settling down. It's a general rule of thumb, when you apply an update, you got to give it at least a few days before everything settles down when it comes to performance and also battery life. Okay, now all the screenshots I took, as you can see, the last few of them were on 60 hertz. Obviously, I was curious, I wanted to see how 90 hertz would affect the battery life, as so many people had said in the reviews and on YouTube that 90 hertz does tend to drain the battery out a bit more. So I was very curious. I thought, okay, it's time for me to be using this phone permanently on 90 hertz for the next few days and see how the battery behaves. Okay, once again, this screenshot was now taken at 90 hertz. Like I said, the battery was from 100% all the way down to 14%, and social media bits and bobs, and I was able to achieve 7 hours and 25 minutes of screen on time. This wasn't as far away from the one which we had before at 60 hertz, where we got, like I said, 7 hours and 28 minutes of screen on time. So my first experience was that switching to 90 hertz has not made any difference whatsoever to the battery life of the OnePlus 7T. Mind you, on the 60, when they had this 90 hertz thing going on, I did hear a lot of battery drain, a lot of people complained, but I think they must have listened to the feedback and they were able to this time around optimize 90 hertz for even more battery life. Okay, once again here, 9%, like I said, 7 hours and 23 minutes of screen on time with 90 hertz refresh rate. Once again, battery down to 10%, typical usage, social media heavy, non-stop, and eventually I was able to achieve a total of 6 hours and 37 minutes of screen on time. Not far from where we were in the previous screenshot, maybe a difference of an hour, but still a very good results, keeping in mind that the screen was running at 90 hertz. Here, once again, I was able to test the standby time on the OnePlus 7T on 12th of December, just past 1 o'clock in the morning. The battery was down to 35%, and I was really curious to see if the new update applied a couple of days ago would make any difference, as the update specifically mentioned that it will make a difference. So eventually, when I took a screenshot at 8:51, just before 9 o'clock in the morning on the same day, as you can see, the battery was down to only 31%. Like I said, from 35%, 1:13 in the morning to almost 9 o'clock, after about 8 to 9 hours, we had only had lost 4% of battery. So this is where eventually the phone was able to settle down. I must also admit, after applying the update, I did reset the phone once more, and I think it did make a difference. Remember guys, when you get an update, please do restart your phone at least a couple of times just to be sure that everything is settled down. Okay, here once again, 90 hertz, battery down to 8%, lots of phone calls, Twitter, Instagram, social media, and eventually I was able to achieve 7 hours and 39 minutes of screen on time. Back to where we were before, in fact, the very best 90 hertz so far. On the first one, we got 7 hours and 25 minutes. On the second one, we got 6 hours and something. And on the third one, we got 7 hours and 39 minutes of screen on time. Very, very interesting. Once again, I tested the standby time on the OnePlus 7T. Battery down to 37% at 1:41 on 20th of December. And then when I checked it again at 9:51, the battery had only drained down to 33%. So once again, from 37 to 33, again, 4% loss in about 9 to 10 hours. Again, which is not bad. This is where it should be. With an efficient 855 plus Snapdragon inside and nice AMOLED screen, this is the kind of figures on standby you expect with Android 10 installed on the phone. Now once again, I took another screenshot, and this time around it was on 4G. As you can see, it says on there 4G plus. I'm on the O2 network. As you guys can see, it says 4G plus here. So I took a screenshot on purely on 4G, running it all day. somebody's pissed off on traffic. Anyways, ignore that for now. So here, like I said, I was able to achieve 5 hours and 39 minutes of screen on time, and that was on 4G. And as you can see, I did heavily use the phone, Instagram, Twitter, Facebook, and News Republic, my reading news app, Amazon, emails, and everything else. And it wasn't too bad. Like I said, 5 hours and 39 or 40 minutes of screen on time with battery down to 5%. So even on 4G plus with around 70% brightness, still the phone was able to give me well over 5 hours of screen on time. So not looking too bad. It's about 2 hours less than what it gave us on Wi-Fi at, by the way, 90 hertz. All of this again, I was able to achieve 6 hours and 3 minutes of screen on time, and this was about a kind of mixed usage. I had a bit of Wi-Fi for a while, but mostly it was 4G, and that's why the stats are pretty much the same as we had on the previous screenshot, just over 6 hours of screen on time with 90 hertz screen and 4G running on mobile. So not looking too bad. Now also, a lot of people asked me how the OnePlus 7T's battery will drain if you're gaming. For nearly half an hour I was playing this fighting game, and I took the first screenshot at 89%, as you guys can see. This is what I took to the screenshot. Wi-Fi was on, and I was playing this on full graphics, not medium graphics, on full graphics. And eventually I stopped at 1502. By the way, I did start at 1429, so stopped at 1502, as you can see in the top left corner. So I was gaming for about half an hour, and in half an hour the battery went down from 89% to about 79%. So it lost 10% in half an hour. This will give you an idea how much battery would drain in an hour's time if you're playing a heavy fighting game on full graphics. As you can see, it lost about 10% in 1 hour. And when it comes to charging, guys, I did use this Bob charging, and sorry I couldn't take the screenshot, but it's very, very fast. In fact, it was so fast, it was scarily fast. So I decided that I won't be using Warp charging in the longer run, as in my opinion, it can damage the battery and reduce its overall life. If you want to ask me specifically about this thing, please leave a comment and we can discuss this later as to why I decided to go back to dash charging and not Warp charging. So guys, that's pretty much for me on the OnePlus 7T. It's a beautiful phone with this lovely, nice blue color. As you can see, the performance has been fantastic. The inbuilt fingerprint sensor has been very reliable so far, hasn't given me any issues whatsoever, and it goes on the first time, and not even once it has failed to me so far. And like I said, very, very fast and quick performance from this handset, and I'm absolutely loving it. So guys, if you got any questions, please feel free to ask me in the comment section, and please give my video a thumbs up and do share it, as it helps. And I shall see you in the next video.